Thank you very much for being here tonight. I am Chad McCullough, and I am this year's host for the 2019 Carmine Caruso International Jazz Trumpet Competition. And this competition has been an important part in many of what have turned out to be legendary jazz trumpet players at the early stages of their career. And we are extremely excited to have it here. This has been an incredible day of activities and merriment and camaraderie, and I couldn't be happier. So thank you for sharing this evening with us. I have the distinct privilege now to introduce Cathy Leach. She is the president of ITG. She was 31 years? 31 years she played the principal in the Knoxville Symphony. Did you do Mahler 5?
Several times.
And she is the trumpet professor at the University of Tennessee. Thank you. So without further ado, please put your hands together for Cathy Leach.
Hi there. It's my privilege to be here tonight, and I have some prepared remarks, so I hopefully won't forget anything. It's my pleasure to be here representing ITG at the Carmine Caruso ITG Jazz Trumpet Solo Competition. I want to tell you a little bit about the International Trumpet Guild, the organization. We have about 4,000 trumpet player members worldwide, and the organization is dedicated to promoting communication among trumpet players and to improving the artistic level of performance, teaching, and literature associated with the trumpet. ITG does many things towards these ends. We put on an annual conference, which next year is at the end of May, and it's in Columbus, Ohio, not too far away. This past summer, we were in Miami for a week before storms. And so we rove around with our conference sites, try to keep things exciting. Members receive a quarterly, really very high quality journal 4 times a year. And members also receive a free CD every year, something that helps trumpet players. The Carmine Caruso competition is one of my favorite of the ITG offerings. Nothing promotes artistry and communication like this past couple of days has. So I think you're gonna enjoy what you hear tonight. We heard the competition itself this afternoon. It's a very special group of finalists that we have here. All of this to say, thank you for being here tonight, whether you're here in person or joining via the live stream. And if you are a trumpet player, or even if you're not a trumpet player and interested in joining ITG, please do so. We need you. I also want to thank Chad for organizing the event to the hilt. He was talking about what an uplifting couple of days it has been. I was here all day today and can say that Chad has really made the whole occasion fun, stimulating, and has just made everybody comfortable. So please thank Chad. Yeah. Thank you also to DePaul University, Dana Hall, Director of Jazz Studies, and anyone here that's on the DePaul University staff that has helped put this event on. We have an ongoing chair of the Caruso competition, Vern Seelert, who has done a tremendous job also. Vern is here. And huge thanks to the Herb Alpert Foundation, without whose financial support we would not be able to do this. I want to thank the competition trio, who is backstage waiting to come out. We heard them all afternoon. They are amazing. And also want to thank the big band that we'll hear later tonight. Tremendous thanks to our three esteemed judges, Charles Tolliver, Tim Hagans, and Ambrose Akinmuserie, who incidentally, he is the one judge who is a former winner of this competition. So you can see the former winners are out there in the world. As Chad was saying, this has been the beginning of careers for quite a few well-known trumpet players. Also want to thank Dixie Burris, ITG treasurer. She signs the checks, keeps us all in line, and she is here in the audience. So Dixie, thank you for everything you do. She's right there. Yeah. So. We also have not only this year's host here, we have the host of the 2015 Caruso competition. He's sitting over here writing up a report, and this is Sean Butterfield. Sean. Yeah. And I'm not sure if he's still here, but I think maybe he is the host of the next competition, the 2021 Caruso competition. Al Hood. Al, are you still here? There he is. Yeah. And they did not need to be here. They came because they wanted to be here and just learn and talk to Chad and see what they can do and what has been done. So this is really a great thing to have everybody here. Finally, I want to thank our finalists. You're about to meet them. Skyler Floe, Andrew Stevens, Dave Adewumi, Jake Baldwin, and Cosimo Boni. It's been a pleasure to hear them. You're in for a treat, and they support each other. It's a great thing to see. So on behalf of ITG, welcome and enjoy the music. Thank you.
I'm extremely fortunate to introduce this trio. They have been friends of mine for a very long time, and we have played a lot of music together, and they were absolutely my first choice, even with Rob now living over the sea. He's living in Paris, but he came back specifically for this, and I couldn't be happier. So please put your hands together on the piano, Rob Clearfield. There's a tune that is composed every year that the finalists do not get until the day before the competition. And it was a very, very beautiful tune. And it was composed by this evening's bass player, a very fine composer. His name is Matt Ullery. These guys have been playing for like 27 hours in the last 24 hours, so they are the heroes of the entire weekend. But it's a trumpet competition, so we only get to acknowledge them a little bit. But on the drums, please put your hands together for Mr. John Deidemeyer. Our first offering for this evening is one of the finalists. He's from Seattle, Washington, which is where I am from, so that's exciting. His name is Skyler Floe. Please put your hands together for Skyler Floe. Up next, please put your hands together from San Francisco, Andrew Stevens. Up next from New Hampshire, Dave Adewumi.
Thank you.
Next up, please put your hands together for Minneapolis, Minnesota, Jake Baldwin.
Thank you.
All right, how about one more round of applause for this incredible rhythm section. Our last finalist comes from Florence, Italy, and his name is Cosimo Boni. Thank you.
this. It's okay. Good evening. How's everybody doing? You doing okay? My name is Dana Hall. I'm the Director of Jazz Studies here at DePaul. And I want to welcome you. I know you've already been welcomed. You're in the second half of the concert. But I wanted to officially welcome you here to our beautiful building and let you know that we have a lot of... How many first time here? Show of hands. Fantastic. So this will be worth your while. And then I won't feel so nervous saying all these things that maybe you don't already know. We have a number of different jazz programming events that happen here in the building. We have 4 large jazz ensembles and 13 small jazz groups that perform concerts, and we have special programming that happens throughout the year, and we want to invite and welcome you to come back for some of that programming. And we usually have those jazz concerts in our fantastic jazz hall, which is up on the second floor, so if you didn't walk up the stairs and take a look at that, don't do it now, because we're about to play the second half of the concert, but maybe afterwards you can take a little detour upstairs and take a look at the jazz hall. It's a beautiful hall. I would be remiss if I didn't give a special thanks. A lot of what's happening over the past few days, in fact, what's been happening for the past year, would not have happened without Chad McCullough and all of his efforts, so please help me thank Chad. He's probably doing something right now. He was doing something at that. I just thanked you. They clapped for you. He was doing something. So, Chad has just been a trooper, gathering all the information, all the intel, working with the folks who I also would like to thank the International Trumpet Guild and the Herb Alpert Foundation. You can give them a nice round of applause for making this possible. So again, welcome and enjoy the music.
It is my absolute joy and pleasure to say what I get to say right now, which is I would like to introduce to you Mr. Charles Tolliver. Piece of Charles's called Emperor's March. Thank you. Charles Tolliver. Charles Tolliver. I feel extremely lucky. This whole couple of days has been really surreal to just get to, you know, see my heroes, and they're hanging out at my house trying to find a fork. So a huge, huge thank you to you and to this incredible big band. So I'll tell you who they are later, but how about it for the band? It's now my complete honor to introduce the next of the adjudicators you'll get to hear this evening. He has been a hero of mine since I was 10 years old. Please put your hands together for the great and tremendous Tim Hagans.
Thank you so much. It's my extreme pleasure to be here at this grand event. You know, when Chad McCullough asked me about a year ago to do this, and he told me, you know, who the other two adjudicators were to be, one of my longtime heroes, Charles Tolliver, and one of my all-time new heroes, you know, Ambrose. So it was a pleasure and an honor to join those three this weekend. And hear them play and hear their stories and hang out. It's been wonderful. And it was great to hear these five young trumpet players this afternoon, because they're the future of this music. And the future is in really good hands. Great hands, actually, I can say. So it's been an inspiring weekend for me to hang out with all these valves that we have. I think if we count it up, it's 12,000 valves, something like that, that we've come across this this weekend. So I'm going to play a ballad. This is a piece that I was writing just at the piano, a kind of a melancholy, beautiful melody, I thought, in May of 1984. And in between working at the piano and practicing, I was reading the paper, and I read that Count Basie passed away that week, and Red Garland, great piano player with Miles Davis, his own trios, and Juan Tizol, the composer of Caravan, all within a 10-day period. And so I was writing this song, and it seemed to be appropriate as a tribute to the joy and the great music that those people made. And then I started thinking about, and this is 1984, everybody who had gone already, you know, and of course that was 35 years ago. So many more of our heroes have left us, and so this is a continuing tribute. It's not a sad song, it's just a very thankful, joyous, beautiful melody for all of our heroes, and it's called Passing Giants.
Thank you.
All right, continuing my fantasy realm reality here. We now get to hear Ambrose Akinmuserie play a beautiful ballad. So please put your hands together for Ambrose Akinmuserie.
Thank you.
All right. Our next guest. No, I don't. That's it. That's it. I just want to take a quick second and thank everyone in the big band, the saxophone section. On the left, on your right, Julie Wood. Rajiv Halim. Nick Mazzarella. Mai Sugimoto. Chef Jeff Bradfield. The trombone section, Tom Matta. Tim Kaufman. Luke Malevich. And Ryan Schultz on the bass trumpet. And the trumpet section, Bob Lark. Russ Johnson. Vern Seelert, Roger Ingram, and Dave Cooper. How about it? We're going to do another of Charles Tolliver's tunes. This is from my favorite of his records. It's a record called Paper Man, and the tune is Right Now. So put your hands together for Mr. Charles Tolliver.
Thank you.
Charles Tolliver. Now is the suspenseful part. Would you guys like to come up here? I have to just say before we go into this whole thing here of the winnings, these guys have been absolutely incredible and actually inseparable this whole time, and everybody from the rhythm section to the officials have commented on how wonderful of people and players they are, so I just want to extend a heartfelt thank you to them for making my job much, much easier. I also feel very, very excited to make a special thank you to Vern Seelert, who is making his way down to the front here. Come on down. Vern was my teacher slightly more than 4 years ago.
Four.
10, 15, more. A long time ago, and I've known Vern for over about 20 years, and I was thrilled when he reached out to me about hosting this, so a huge thank you from me to Vern. I could just keep stalling, and these guys are going to get so thick, they're going to throw up soon.
Cathy, do we have,
I also want to bring back to the stage Cathy Leach and Dixie Burris.
Hello again. We're approaching the end of a glorious day here, and the judges had a wealth of musicianship to choose from today. I want to thank all the finalists for all the work they've put into this, from choosing their tunes to recording their initial audition tape and the going through the application process, which I hear was lots of fun. Yeah, so they've put a lot of work into being here, so bravo, first of all, to all of you. We're awarding two prizes tonight, and start with the second prize, and that will be awarded to Andrew Stevens. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Are we get a picture?
Standing on tiptoes. Yeah. Thank you. Great. Right. And first prize will be awarded to Dave Adewumi. Neglected to mention the big check here by with Chad. First prize is $10,000, second prize, $5,000. All right. Thank you, everybody.
I said I wouldn't host this competition unless I got to be Ed McMahon for a minute. I am going to bring out Tim Hagans one more time. We're going to bring out Tim Hagans. We're going to do a little super trumpet end of the festival tune. I've said thank you so many times to all of these people that have made this possible, but again, I just want to say thank you. This is really, really a special thing, and it's been the better part of a year of my life putting this together, so thank you for joining us. Thank you for celebrating with us. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thad just told me to tell some jokes while he gets his horn, because if this trumpet thing doesn't work out, I'm going to work on a stand-up routine thing, but I guess the jokes are going on back there. We're going to close with a traditional trumpet type of tune, and Lee Morgan, Freddie Hubbard, Herbie Hancock made these types of tunes very popular on the first tracks of Blue Note Records in the 1960s. And it's called the Boogaloo. And we're going to play a pretty scary one. And so this is called Boo. And we're going to feature everybody up here in this this massive group that has three valves on their horns, all these great trumpet players. So thank you so much. This is Boo. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
the guys. Take a bow, guys. Ambrose. The entire band. Does anybody have any arrangements for 36 trumpets and big band? Thank you very much for joining us. It's been an absolute dream of mine to be here with you. Thank you. Thank you.